causes impairment in learning, visual, spatial, motor skills, and executive function. It's very important to differentiate between delirium and early postoperative cognitive dysfunction. Delirium typically occurs within first three postoperative days, whereas cognitive dysfunction occurs at the end of first week, and it has no effect on consciousness and duration, and the duration is typically prolonged. Cognitive dysfunction is subclassified into short term and long term. Short term typically occurs within 6 weeks, and long term is something which lasts more than 6 months after the surgery. Diagnosis is based on specific and sensitive neuropsychological tests that examine different cognitive domains. The testing is performed several weeks after the surgery, and compared with the baseline test performed preoperatively. It means that we have to, for diagnosing this, we need to have preoperative tests performed. The commonly used neuropsychological tests, these are the commonly used neuropsychological tests, among which the trial making test is the most commonly used. In all these neuropsychological tests, many domains such as visual tasking, visual ability, word finding ability, memory, and sensory motor speed, and many of these are assessed. The universally accepted definitions, there are two definitions. The first one being worsening in cognitive performance in at least two neuropsychological tests in the battery, with the test performance defined as significantly deteriorated if the patient's pre- and post-operative test score decrement is at least one standard deviation, the standard deviation being determined on the distribution of the pre-operative scores in the patient sample. The more simpler definition is, if there is 20% decrement in the test score from baseline on at least 20% of the tests. Early evaluation should be performed at least 7 days after the procedure to avoid the effects of sedatives, post-surgical pain, sleep deprivation, and patient fatigue. Now, what is the incidence of postoperative cognitive dysfunction? It's been found that out of Nikhil Patel has done a systemic review of 94.